Today I'm going to take this and turn it into this. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. Today we are talking about how to use your Fujifilm camera as a webcam. Some of you have asked how to do this and there's some definite steps you need to take if you want to use your Fujifilm camera for things like Skype or online video meetings. Why would you want to use a DSLR or a mirrorless camera in the first place instead of just a webcam? The first reason is quality. There is no webcam on earth that can look as good as the video from, say, this beautiful 35mm f2.0 lens. So choice of lenses is a big factor. You also have much more control over picture quality, audio quality, color balance, etc. And the quality of your video and audio matters, especially if you're in the photography business, say, doing an online meeting with clients. Nothing is more unprofessional than a shaky webcam with awful, crappy audio. I call it SWACA, shaky webcam with awful, crappy audio. Don't want that. So, how do we use a Fujifilm camera as a webcam? First off, you need to be sure that your Fujifilm camera has a mini HDMI port on it. Obviously, the X series cameras such as the X-T2, 3, 4, X-H1, X-Pro, all of those have them. Not only do you need an HDMI port, but you also need to be sure that your camera can output what is called clean HDMI. This means HDMI that doesn't have the menu information in it, right? You don't see the camera settings in it, it's just pure, clean HDMI with no menus. If you're unsure if your camera has this, do a Google search for your camera model and then put clean HDMI output after that in the Google search. I can tell you that a number of the Fujifilm X series cameras such as the X-T2, X-T3, X-T4, X-H1 do offer this feature. Now the second thing you're going to need is some way to power your camera continuously without using these crappy 2-second lasting Fujifilm batteries. So for the X-T series you can use the battery grip and simply plug that into the camera and then the battery grip into the wall and you're good to go. If you don't have a battery grip, you can get this dummy battery which plugs into the camera and then this plugs into the wall. I'll have a link to both of these down below. The bottom line is that you cannot be using batteries alone as obviously you don't want them running out in the middle of your video webcast. The third thing you're going to need is a mini HDMI to regular HDMI cable. I own a lot of these and probably the best bang for the buck is the Amazon Basics or Cable Matters HDMI cables. I'll have a link to those below as well for the ones that will work. The fourth thing that you're going to need is an HDMI video capture device. This is a device that is connected between your camera and the computer, and it basically takes the signal from the camera and translates it such that your computer thinks that a webcam is attached to it. For today's demo, I'm going to be using and recommending the Elgato CamLink 4K. I think overall, this is the best one. However, I will have links in the description below to some other brands as well. Once you have the HDMI capture device, you then connect your camera to the device, and then you connect the device to your computer through the USB port. Okay, so now you have your camera connected to your computer via this HDMI capture device. Next, you need to make some very important setting changes within the camera menu itself. I'm gonna demo this on the X-T3, but the process is very similar if you have different Fujifilm cameras. The first thing you are gonna wanna do absolutely is go into your power management settings, and make sure that auto power off is set to off. You don't want the camera powering down in the middle of your webcast. The next thing you want to check is in the video settings, make sure that HDMI output info display is set to off. The reason I had to change cameras was because when I switched it off, it disconnected it from my demo screen, so I had to use the phone to show you the setting. Next setting you want to make is 4K HDMI standby quality. For that, if you are using the CamLink, you're going to want to set that to 4K. If you don't see your camera recognized in your video meeting software on your computer, try toggling this setting to FHD. It may fix the problem, particularly if it only accepts 1080 input. I recommend also turning on Face Eye Auto Detect. You'll find that in your video settings. Simply have it Eye Auto. I also like to put the camera in C, continuous autofocus mode. And the rest of the settings on here are basically the same exposure, color balance, etc., that you're already used to. And that's the great thing about it, is whatever settings you make on here will carry over into your video webcast. Okay, so now I've connected this studio camera that you're seeing me through right now in the same manner that I just described to you. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to open up Skype on this computer and see if it recognizes it as a webcam. Now I'm going to show you something really cool. Okay, so I have Skype open right here. Inside your meeting software, whether it's Skype or Zoom, you have an area where you can select your video source and your audio source. So in this case, I'm going to select my video source, and there it is, CamLink 4K. And here we go. Okay. It's working. Here's what I can do. I've selected CamLink 4K, but I could choose a different webcam. So I have a webcam right there. So I could say, you know, this one, and then boom, it changes to this webcam right here. And as you can see, the quality just isn't as good. But now I'm going to go ahead and switch it back to the CamLink. That is now my Fuji, right, that you're watching me on now. Remember, I have not pressed the record button on the X-T3. It's not recording anything. It's not recording to SD. It's just sitting there on. So theoretically, I could leave this camera on for hours, as long as it's plugged in, right, and it's not set to auto turn off. But check this out. I'm going to walk over here. All right, now let's change the film sim. Let's see if we can do that. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to press on my shortcut for that. And let's change it to, I don't know, the black and white one we all love. Okay, let's try that. All right, now we're in black and white. All right, let's turn everything on and see if it works. Okay, oh my goodness, check it out. Look at that. Okay, so it works. If you change the film sim on the Fujifilm, when you have it connected as a webcam, that will affect the picture. And so you can use these film sims for your webcam, or you can create your own custom color balance profile. Very, very cool. Kind of a neat little trick you probably didn't know about. Now, as far as audio goes, your camera will be recording audio from the internal microphone built into the camera. That being said, most webcam programs like Skype, Zoom, etc., will default to your computer's microphone. And in many cases, that might work for you. But if it doesn't sound that good, don't skip on this step. Nothing ruins good video more than crappy audio. I see this all the time. The number one tip for good audio is to get the microphone as close to you as possible. So if your camera is more than a few feet away, or if your computer's built-in audio sounds terrible, then get yourself an external mic and plug it into the external mic jack on the camera. Or you can plug it into your computer and select that audio source. So for example, if it says default device, that would be whatever audio source your computer is normally capturing audio from. But I can change it to CamLink 4K. And if I do that, it is then going to use either the camera's built-in audio, or it will use an external microphone if you have it connected to the output jack right here. Does that make sense? Lastly, you could pick another microphone that you have connected to your computer through USB, and that is a great option. I will have a link down below to some microphones that you can use either to connect directly to your computer with USB or to connect to your camera. The bottom line here is that you want to try and have as professional a video and audio setup as you can if you're going to be meeting with clients. You may decide that, you know, purchasing a good 1080p webcam is the best way to go and avoids all the hassle of trying to use your high-end mirrorless or DSLR camera. But no matter what setup, camera, or system that you're using, make sure that you have good audio, good lighting, and some attention to camera placement and where you are in frame and even what's behind you, right? That will go a long way toward making your online video sessions a lot more professional. I really hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you did, please give it the like and subscribe, and I will see you again in another video real soon. Over and out. Okay, where is my phone? I have lost my phone. What the heck? Phone anywhere. The only thing I use my Apple Watch for is finding the phone. All right. Right next to me the whole time.